1989, when Bill Snyder took over, the worst in the history of college football. He's already worked one miracle in Manhattan and working on his second. Back in coaching after 3 years out and his third year back in, they're 7-0. Kansas State won the toss and deferred, so Anthony Cantelli kicked off with a strong breeze, and it'll be a touchback. Oklahoma will begin from its own 20, led by one of our impact players, brought to you by Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry. Landry Jones, third in the country in passing yards, 370 per game, behind only Case Keenum and Seth Dagey. Ryan Broyles is the all-time leading receiver in the history of major college football. And Dominique Whaley, their leading rusher, back in action after missing last week's game against Texas Tech. He was out with flu-like symptoms, which used to just be called the flu. Now it's flu-like symptoms. They're averaging better than 44 points per game. Oklahoma. Hand it off. The Roy Finch coming around. And he has a first down across the 30-yard line. An 11-yard gain for Finch. Ordinarily a running back. And there's an injured player on the field. It's Dominique Whaley. Mentioned their leading rusher, who missed last week with the flu. Face down on the field turf here after one play from scrimmage. That would be a huge loss for Oklahoma. He's second in the Big 12 in rushing, over 104 yards per game. There he is on the right of your screen. Oh. As he goes to block, he gets rolled from behind by Arthur Brown, the middle linebacker for Kansas State.
Always hate to see that. And Dominique Whaley, you can see, was just a walk-on out of Langston University, and he's done everything and more. He's exceeded all expectations as a player and as a person.
Back live in Manhattan, Kansas, where the Oklahoma medical staff placed an air cast on the left leg of Dominique Whaley. Bill Snyder again out there to offer his best wishes to Whaley, who's one of the great individual stories in college football this season. There have been a lot of wonderful articles written about Dominique, including a major piece a couple of weeks ago in Sports Illustrated. It talked about how as recently as a year and a half ago, the spring of 2010, as a walk-on in this Oklahoma program, he was working at a local sub shop, would work for 3 or 4 hours a day and then race over to practice. Not highly recruited out of high school. Went to Langston University, an NAIA school, where he was a reserve. Decided he wanted to transfer to big-time football. When he approached the Oklahoma coaches, they were skeptical. I mean, if you're a reserve at Langston University, no disrespect to them, can you really be expected to be much of a player at Oklahoma? But when he told them what he could run in the 40, what he could lift, and some of his other physical attributes, they worked him out. They saw that he wasn't making it up. And he quickly emerged as a factor in their program. You hate to see anybody get hurt like this, Matt, particularly a young man like this who's gone through so much to get to this point. And unfortunately, it seems he's had a major injury. So one play from scrimmage, an 11-yard gain by Finch. Now Landry Jones swings it out to Ryan Broyles. And a good tackle in the open field by Nigel Malone, junior corner. And an excellent defender. He has 4 interceptions, tied for the Big 12 lead. Oklahoma will go quickly, as the Sooners usually do. The fake to Finch. He'll likely take over as the featured back, and the pass on target. Kenny Stills out of bounds across midfield to the Kansas State 47. And a first down for Oklahoma after gain of 21.
They're not wasting any time. And like you mentioned earlier, Sean, they don't. And when they see that you have any kind of hesitation defensively, they really step on the pedal.
Finch did a good job last week stepping in for Whaley. Rushed for 93 yards. That was a career high. They fake it to him. Jones with a lot of time. Deep down the middle of the field and thrown up for grabs. Intended for Stills, but broken up by Nigel Malone.
Not a good throw. Remember a week ago against Texas Tech, he did not start sharply. This time, This ball hangs. This should have been an interception. It hung and was thrown behind. Landry Jones has to come out and start sharp. A week ago, it didn't happen. His first attempt there was no day at the beach.
And they fell behind 31-7 to Texas Tech last Saturday night after an hour and a half rain delay in Norman before the game started. Jones throws short for Finch. He has a first down and a good move to get extra yardage down inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. A gain of 18. Tyson Hartman, Jordan Volker made the tackle. Five receivers now for Jones. Four-man rush. They don't get near him. And another pass on target. This one to the tight end, James Hanna. Banged down by safety Ty Zimmerman. They're going to mark it right on the 19. Looks like another first down with a 10-yard gain.
Kansas State defensively has been pretty stingy. They're just spreading out the field right now. And with no pressure on Landry Jones, he's just patiently picking his spots.
They're going to measure it. The down marker see a second down in inches.
You know, Sean, as a player, when one of your teammates goes out with an injury like that and you watch him in an air cast and they have to take him off the field on the cart, one of the things you must do is get it out of your mind and focus quickly. You have to be able to focus on who you're playing against and what you're doing right away. And sometimes it's difficult, especially when you have a close relationship with a guy, because it's about people. It's a people game.
And these Sooners in particular know better than anybody how hard Whaley worked to get in position to be a standout player on one of the best teams in the country. It is a first down after the measurement, first and 10 from the 19. Jones gets rid of the ball so quickly, he's been sacked only three times this year. Only Andrew Luck of Stanford has been sacked less often. He's been taken down twice. Finch bangs in the line of scrimmage, lunges forward for a couple. Tackled by Trey Walker and Ty Zimmerman. It is a Kansas State defense much improved against the run. Last year they were one of the worst in the country. They gave up more than 230 yards per game rushing. This year that number is 94 yards per game on the ground. They've gone from 119th in the country, second to last, to 13th against the run.
Well, you saw right there Arthur Brown in the middle. He's one of the main keys. That kid, he sees things quickly, makes great decisions.
After the fake to Finch, another open receiver, Ryan Broyles inside the five, lunge for the pylon, and no signal yet. Touchdown, Oklahoma.
Watch the instinct to get into the end zone. Extend the ball and gets inside, hits the pylon. Does not step out of bounds at all. And because he steps inside first, he's in bounds. And now, even though he's going out,
he's out of bounds there.
You have to see where the ball is when he's touching that line. It looks like it may be hitting simultaneously. Not only that, at the same time.
Wow. Penn State is so proud of you right now. Greg Burks is the referee leading this Big 12 crew.
There's the step.
And I think that's the step where he was out of bounds, yeah. His left foot, and he's not yet to the pylon.
Right there, so it's short. What a great effort, though, by Broyles.
And Tyson Hartman got enough of him, it seems, to prevent the touchdown. They'll spot it, you would think, near the one-yard line. David Dumas is the replay official out of the Big 12. Ryan Broyles knows how to get to the end zone. 44 career touchdown receptions. Fourth in the history of FBS football. Leader among active players. The all-time record is 60 by Jarrett Dillard of Rice. And Broyles would have to have a phenomenal finish to his career to get
there. After further review, the runner stepped out of bounds. The ball will be placed at the one-yard line, second down.
Regardless of where they spot it, it doesn't negate what Ryan Broyles has turned into as a slot receiver. He's the top slot receiver in all of college football. And at the next level, he'll do the same thing because, Sean, he does some things innately very well. And he's just got a feel for not only zone man-to-man, but at the top of his routes is what makes him pretty darn good.
Passed Taylor Stubblefield of Purdue earlier this year to become the all-time leader in catches. At this level of college football, he's got a shot at the all-time receiving yardage mark as well by the end of the season. First and goal from the one. A direct snap to Blake Bell, who came in for Landry Jones. And a touchdown for Oklahoma. Bell, listed on the depth chart as their third-string quarterback, came in to run that play, and he caps an 80-yard, nine-play drive.
Well, just one little bit of hesitation, and then this is what Blake Bell sees. All purple. There is the parting of the ocean right there, and he just follows a great job of his offensive line providing that.
A lot of people wondered, would Oklahoma be engaged after the huge disappointment of last Saturday? And clearly the Sooners are. A skirmish on the field before the game and an impressive opening drive capped by Blake Bell.
Oklahoma medical staff who were able to confirm that Dominique Whaley did suffer a lower left leg injury. They did say it's much too early to tell the extent of the injury. They did cart him off to the Kansas State Medical Facility for x-rays. Now, you guys, as you recall, Dominique did miss last week's game because of the flu. Right before kick, I talked to Bob Stoops about the impact he would have returning to the field. Stoops said you can't even measure the impact he has because he just has the ability to make everyone around him better. So certainly this OU staff and team missing Whaley's presence on the field.
You know, Heather, what you just said right there, you cannot measure that, Sean. The ability of a player to make others around him better is one of those things that's hard to quantify, but it is, you only usually see it when it's missing. And when the guy's gone, that's when you struggle.
Patrick O'Hara will kick off to the hottest kickoff return man in the country right now. Tyler Lockett has returned a kickoff for a touchdown each of the last 2 weeks, so they squib it to prevent him from running one back. Looks like that might have been touched by a Kansas State player. They're throwing flags for a kickoff out of bounds.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he did. It looked like he lunged for it and may have touched it. And if that's the case, they'll pick the right there. Not touched there, but at the end.
On the kicking team. First down.
It's Alex Rebeck who was close to it but didn't appear to touch it, so the ball come out to the 40-yard line. And here come the Kansas State Wildcats. An offense that sharply contrasts Oklahoma in terms of style. See a lot of fullbacks and tight ends. A lot of good old-fashioned option football. With their leading rusher, the quarterback, Colin Klein, junior from Loveland. Holds onto it on the first play, gets a yard. Here's Reese Davis.
Sean, the end of the Arkansas-Vanderbilt game. Vanderbilt had driven from inside their own 10 down to chip shot field goal range, and Casey Spear went wide right, and Arkansas escapes by 3.
Wow, they were behind for a lot of that game. Heartbreaking loss for Vanderbilt. Klein, second among all college football quarterbacks, the FBS level in rushing, behind only Denard Robinson of Michigan. On target to Tyler Lockett for a 5-yard gain to the 46. It'll be 3rd down and 4. Here are the impact players on offense for K-State, brought to you by Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry. John Hubert is their leading running back, averaging 91 yards per game rushing. And Lockett, the freshman, has come on in recent weeks as both a receiver and with those 2 kickoff returns against Texas Tech and Kansas. The only player in the history of the program to run kickoffs back for touchdowns in consecutive games. 3rd down 4. Klein faked the run. He's in trouble and sacked by Tom Wart. back at the 35-yard line. Was one of those three defensive starters who didn't play last week against Texas Tech because of injury, and he's made an immediate impact here this afternoon.
Well, he should turn around and give Tony Jefferson a good kiss, because Jefferson, number one, takes the primary receiver away, and he is not there whatsoever, and because of that, Wart gets the sack.
Ryan Doerr to punt for K-State. Junior from Katy, Texas, a good kick. Fielded by Ryan Broyles. Has some running room now. Flag down. The punter, Doerr, slowed him down and helped take him down at the 40-yard line, but there's a flag back of the 33. Broyles is the career active leader in the country in punt return yardage.
Holding number two receiving team. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down. Timeout.
Coming parade rolled through Aggieville, followed by other homecoming festivities last night. Our Liberty Mutual drive recap. First time Oklahoma had the ball, they went 80 yards in 9 plays. Landry Jones missed on only 1 of 6 throws. His stand-in Blake Bell scored his first career touchdown with a 1-yard run on just his 4th career carry. Brandon Williams comes in at running back now, listed as 4th string on the depth chart. They hand it off to Trey Franks coming across the formation. Similar to the first play from scrimmage on the opening drive. Arthur Brown the stop. Ball be marked at the 28-yard line. It's a gain of 5.
And Arthur Brown's an active player. He runs extremely well, really knows, has really good instincts inside. But he can go sideline to sideline.
Second and 5 from the 28. Line to make the 33. Out of the pistol, the handoff to Brandon Williams, and he's taken down behind the line of scrimmage by David Garrett, the cornerback.
Nice read. Nice read, and it's a replace principle. You're going to watch him. As soon as he sees that down block, you're the free hitter. You've got to be able to make the play, and he does, and sets up this 3rd and long, Sean. And this is where Kansas State has to win. 3rd and long.
Loss of 5 on the previous play. Five wide receivers. Short pass. He needs to get to the 33. Might have been a face mask as well. Roy Finch ripped down, and there are 3, now 4 flags on the field. Emmanuel Lemoore didn't mean to, but he did. Just grabbed the face mask and ripped him down.
Personal foul, face mask, 23, defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
As you watch this face mask at the end of this play, look at the design of the play and what Oklahoma is doing. They're spreading everyone out and allowing Finch, with the great quickness and underneath stuff, to be isolated in space. That, they feel, is an advantage for them.
11-yard gain, then 15 more for the penalty. 8.5 to go, first quarter, 7-0 Oklahoma. And they're back at midfield. Jones throws to another open receiver. And it's Broyles. Had to wait for a low throw. Went out of bounds just inside the 34-yard line. Chased out by Nigel Malone. Was it a catch?
Oh, yes, it was. Got his hands underneath that. Had to wait on that ball. There was some pressure, like you said, Sean. Broyles is able to make the catch.
17-yard gain. The Sooners have come out like a team determined not to be upset for the 2nd week in a row. Jones, plenty of time, and another receiver. First down to DeJuan Miller. Senior from New Jersey, just his 9th catch of the year. He's down at the 11-yard line.
Here's one of the qualities that Landry Jones has: decision making. As he sees the pressure and feels it, he's able to see the whole field and pick the right guy. Well done.
Gain of 23. 8 out of 9 today. His completion percentage had been dropping in recent weeks. First four games of the year, he was over 71%. The last three games, just 59% completion percentage. They bring pressure. Brown, the linebacker, blitzed, and the pass is broken up by Malone. Looked like Brown might have been early across the line of scrimmage, but no flags on the play. It'll be 2nd and 10.
That's the second, only the second errant pass, and just both times he was a little behind, Sean, on his throws. But a good start, much better than he was a week ago.
They're not good in the red zone. That's surprising with all their talent. 85th in the country, with just 56% touchdowns. Jones with a blitz coming after him, forced to throw quickly, and James Hanna was the intended receiver.
Looks like he was expecting Hanna to be able to make that break a little sooner and get out in the flat. And you know, when you watch this offense, you know, down here, Sean, in this red zone, everything's shrunk, and so it's a smaller field, and what they like to use is space, and they don't have as much space down here. One of the things that complicates their red zone offense.
Finch on the right hip of Landry Jones. Two receivers to each side, including the tight end Hanna to the left. Jones zings one back of the end zone, caught. Touchdown, DeJuan Miller.
Sean, one of the qualities you look for in a receiver is strong hands. And watch him. There's the hands on the ball. And there's the foot inbounds. 1 foot in college football equals 6 points. And that's 6 points.
And clearly in with room to spare, and the official beautifully positioned. An impressive start for Oklahoma. Two possessions, two long scoring drives. And the extra point good by Michael Honeycutt. And this crowd that had the building rocking when the game started has been silenced by two quick strikes by Oklahoma. Landry Jones and number 9 Oklahoma leading Kansas State 14-0 just past the midway point of this first quarter in Manhattan, Kansas, against the undefeated K-State Wildcats. Come in 7-0. But Landry Jones has picked apart the Wildcat defense. Bill Snyder, during the commercial break, spent a lot of time over by the bench talking to the defense.
Sean is going to have to start up front because they have not been getting much pressure at all. And he's been able to sit back there, survey the field, and make the good choice. The best way to handle that is to knock him down.
There's Patrick O'Hara to kick off again. Will he give Lockett a shot, or will he roll one down the field again? This one is a sky kick. Caught at the 30-yard line. Tremaine Thompson out of bounds. Out of bounds back near the 40-yard line. And he was one of the deep men. They were anticipating the short kick, so he was able to catch it on the fly. And O'Hara got just enough of a piece from the steerum toward the sideline. 32-yard return officially. They marked it at the 39 of Oklahoma. So in need of a spark, might have received one yet again from the kickoff return group. Well, Colin Klein, the quarterback, with John Hubert right behind him in the pistol. Klein, the fake, throws one deep in a double coverage. And incomplete. Let's go to Sports Center right now. Here's Reese Davis.
And Sean, Sports Center right now is presented by Discover Card. Carl Edwards is going to start on the pole for Sunday's Sprint Cup race in Martinsville, 1 Eastern on ESPN. Qualifying a wash, Edwards a points leader. That's why he gets to do the backflip and start first. Louisville Athletic Director Tom Juritz says that he won't give a long-term commitment to the Big East because he has to do what's best for his university.
So sad what has happened to the Big East.
Falling apart, yep, I agree.
Affects so many people. And so many people involved in this realignment nonsense should be ashamed of themselves for what's happening. Klein weaves down to the 37-yard line. Pickup of two. It'll be third down and eight. He was chopped down by Sam Proctor, backup safety.
You know, Sean, when you watch this Kansas State offense, you have Colin Klein, who makes very good decisions. But the only explosive guy they have is Lockett. And they tried to hit him there earlier. Oklahoma knew that right away. They put a safety on the underneath side and went man on the outside. So they're going to take away the big explosive player and make everybody else beat them.
They live by methodically marching up and down the field. They can't get too far behind. Klein running for his life. Got a block from Hubert. Give him enough room just to throw it away. Oklahoma, one of the great pass rush teams in the country. Four sacks per game, second in the nation.
Well, and they're not afraid to bring pressure. And here comes Jefferson again, number one. But because they can afford to bring pressure because they like their matchups outside. They have the speed to be able to run with the Kansas State receivers. And if they just handle one guy and keep the safety to that side to lock it, they like what they're doing.
Everybody thought they were going to punt, but instead it's a 54-yard field goal try for Anthony Cantelli, who'd be the longest of his career. He does have a stiff wind at his back. He got plenty of it, and it is good.
Okie smokes, Sean. That would have been good from 60.
Long attempt this year has been 49 yards, which is also the longest made field goal of his career by Cantelli before that one. John McDonough, Matt Millen, Heather Cox back in Manhattan, Kansas. Breezy today. Very pleasant day for late October here a couple of hours west of Kansas City. Wind gust today in excess of 25 miles per hour. Anthony Cantelli, the junior from Wichita, helped use that wind to kick the longest field goal of his career, 54 yards. Now he kicks off with the wind again. Roy Finch downs it, and here's Reese Davis.
All right, Taco Bell studio update, Sean. Texas A&M and Missouri went into overtime. James Franklin and Marcus Lucas, beautifully thrown ball. That put Mizzou up by 7. And then on defense, Ryan Tannehill on fourth down has it batted down. So now Missouri's 4-4 overall, 2-3 in the Big 12, and 1-0 in the SEC.
We're in some heartbreaking losses this year for Texas A&M. They're now 3-2 in the Big 12. They'll be at Oklahoma next week. Third time on offense for the Sooners. They've had two long touchdown drives. They start this one with a handoff to Roy Finch. Out to the 25. Here's Heather.
Sean, you mentioned that Bill Snyder came over to the defense during the last timeout. Well, he was able to eavesdrop, and Coach Snyder preached, as only Coach Snyder can, stay together. Don't be that weak link. I never said it was going to be easy. We're not out of this. Play the game. They can hold the Sooners on this possession, Sean.
You wonder if they can. They really haven't come close to stopping the Sooners on the first two drives. Finch again behind Jones. And he's ahead of the 28. It'll be third down and two. David Garrett made the tackle. He's the second leading tackler on the defense at just 5'8", 175 pounds.
And third down is where they have to win, Sean. As they had him third and long a few times, weren't able to handle it. Now here's third and two or three. They've got
Blake
to get
Bell
off the
comes
field.
In at quarterback again. He came in at the goal line and scored the rushing touchdown, the first score of the game. Flag thrown now by the referee.
12 men in the huddle. They're going to take 5 yards.
Illegal
off.
Substitution. Offense. 5 yard penalty. Third down.
Now Landry Jones isn't used to coming off the field, so when he does, there might be some confusion.
They have big Trey Millard in there.
Yep. And Aaron Rutkowski, who might have been the guilty party based on the reaction of the coaches. So Jones back on the field. Third down and seven now. Just a four-man rush. And again, all day to throw for Jones. And he's on target. What a throw to Ryan Broyles for a first down. They had men in front of Broyles, behind Broyles, beside Broyles. And there was only one place that throw could be, right there. 27-yard gain. They come up very quickly. Broyles, nice move. And then Zimmerman, who got deep the first time, made the tackle after David Garrett slowed him up.
Sean, they were able to have that throw to Broyles for one reason. He had all kinds of time to throw. You mentioned just a four-man rush. This offensive line from Oklahoma has given him, Landry Jones, all kinds of time to throw.
But not many quarterbacks could put it into that tight a window.
No, I agree. It was over the safety. They had him robbering in the middle, just sitting inside looking for anything.
On the K-State 49, second and nine, 4 minutes to go, first quarter. Broyles ducks down inside the 42-yard line. They'll bring up third down and two. Tyson Hartman credited with the tackle. And here's Bell back in. Big guy, 6'6", 245. Redshirt freshman from Wichita. One of seven Kansans on the Oklahoma roster back in his home state today. Faked the handoff, then lost the ball. And has to go down at the 44-yard line. So they lose a couple. He might have just barely grazed Finch enough to knock it out of the hands of Bell. Fourth and four. And Bob Stoops, after some consideration, sends the punt team on. Tress Way, one of the best punters in the country, averaging 41 this year. His career average is over 44. Best in Oklahoma history. Punting into that stiff wind. Play clock running out. They just do snap it in time. And Lockett made the fair catch. Line of scrimmage will be the 12. What a job Bill Snyder has done. They were the worst program in the country when he got hired late in 1988, started in the 89 season. In his first stint, encompassing 17 years, 6-11 win seasons, 136 wins. He retired. Ron Prince came in for three. They drifted toward mediocrity, so Snyder was coaxed out of retirement at age 69. And he's working his magic again, called the miracle in Manhattan the first time. Bob Stoops, reminiscing before the game, talked about when he was here as an assistant at the beginning of Snyder, you didn't need a ticket. They just let you in if you wanted to come into the stadium. They were averaging about 13,000 fans a home game. Facilities were poor. Interest was low. Bill Snyder said they were talking about dropping down to a lower level of college football, maybe even giving up the program. Very few people wanted the job. Snyder took it over after a long stint with Hayden Fry as an assistant at Iowa. He's done one of the best coaching jobs in the history of college football. Colin Klein after a two-yard gain. Second and eight. Under 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Handed it off to John Hubert, and he goes nowhere. Aaron Colvin up at the line of scrimmage, and Corey Nelson, a linebacker, stopped the play right at the line, third down and eight.
The way he's gotten it done, Sean, has been with good fundamental football and team football. And what he doesn't have, which is what you're seeing right now, he doesn't have team speed. And so for him to try to get an edge against this Oklahoma team, which does have great team speed, is difficult. So they try to run the option and gain a half a man by using the quarterback, but still it's been negated by the speed of the Sooners.
Minus 1 yards of offense here in the first quarter. The point set up by the kickoff return. Klein pulls it down and gets away. Looks like he lost a shoe, but he got the first down. And they want a late hit out of bounds on that K-State sideline. The fans do as well. He made it to the 25, 11 yards and a first down.
Again, nowhere to throw. Just good job of coverage, and so he's forced to pull it down. But watch Washington 91 at the
that
end.
That should be a penalty.
Yeah,
he's way you. Out of bounds. How did they not flag that?
Yeah, he didn't even start tackling him until he was out of bounds.
First down of a quarter of this game. Hubert threw a big haul. Another first down. They went nearly the full quarter without one. Now they have consecutive first downs. That's a 14-yard run by the sophomore from Waco, Texas.
Now we start talking about decision-making by Colin Klein, and it's as much in the run game as it is in the pass game. Now, in the pass game, Sean, it's been stunted because of the coverage down the field. And so he takes his talent there to the run game.
Hubert, eighth in the Big 12 in rushing, 40th in the country at 91 yards per game. Really, the two of them, the entire run game. Flea Flicker, Klein, throws for Harper. Incomplete, flags down. Pass interference on Tony Jefferson.
It turns out to be a good play. The great play would have been a catch by Harper.
Pass interference. Number one, defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Well, there's the rub in college football, of course. It's 15 yards from the line of scrimmage instead of marking at the spot of the foul inside the 20-yard line.
Well, he just can't quite run away from Jefferson. Part of the reason is he's kind of holding on to his arm. But having said that, the difference between a good play and a great play is completing the play. Harper needed to make that catch.
Could well be the last play of the quarter. 4 seconds to go. K-State at the 47 of Oklahoma. They toss it to Lockett. Good call. Starting to find a little bit of a rhythm now on offense, ignited by that first down run by Colin Klein.
The Lockett rocket. He's got the speed they need.
10 yards and a first down. It brings us to the end of the first quarter here in Manhattan.
Tony's Asheries makes everything taste great.
To ESPN's College Football presented by Cars.com. Oklahoma leading Kansas State 14-3 at the end of one quarter. As we continue, Dr. Pepper's road to the championship. Dominique Whaley back on the Oklahoma sideline, but obviously not going to return today. We'll try to learn more about the extent of his left leg injury. First and 10, Kansas State. Movement along the line of scrimmage.
False start. Number 77, offense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Colton Freeze, the right guard. And another trademark of Bill Snyder football is limit the penalties. Don't do the little things to beat yourself. Discipline, persistence, consistency among the many principles that Bill Snyder preaches to his team. And they have bought in. First and 15. Klein with a design run. Squirts through holes. He might go. Touchdown.
John, what were those qualities you were just talking about? Because they're embodied in that player. Persistent, consistency, anything to do with the team, and oh, by the way, he's talented.
Yeah, belief in yourself. I mean, it was 14-0. It was looking bleak. Snyder went over. Reached to believe in each other, continue the fight. Look like it might be a blowout. Now it's very much a football game after the 42-yard run by Colin Klein, who is a touchdown-making machine. It's his 15th rushing touchdown of the season. His 11th in the last four games. as they go 88 yards in six plays. Kansas State has scored 10 unanswered points. They're back within four of Oklahoma.
Watch these two have these two. And then here's a key block. Watch Wilson right on Wart, and then Finney right here. And now that allows you to get to the second level. Now the second level is on the runner. And look at this. Watch the power by Klein. Goes right through Jefferson, and then it's off to the races. Well executed up front. And Klein finishes it.
And he's a big man. He's 6'5", 226 pounds, and obviously with terrific speed as well. You have to think, Matt, the biggest play of the game right now is that third down and eight when K-State was on its own 14-yard line. It looked like they might sack Colin Klein. He took off, got their first down of the game. Wound up being the beginnings of their first touchdown drive. High kick into the wind. Caught by one of the up men, and he's tackled immediately. Marshall Musil, the backup fullback, did well to catch that ball that was fluttering in the breeze. College football action continues tonight on ESPN, ESPN2, and ABC. A full slate of top-ranked teams. Number six, Stanford and USC should be a good one. We saw that Cardinal team last week. They've won 15 in a row now, the longest winning streak in the country. But USC coming off that wire-to-wire win at Notre Dame. Andrew Luck and Matt Barkley on display tonight, 8 Eastern on ABC.
That is going to be fun. Probably the two best, certainly in the same game. Those guys can really wing it.
Landry Jones swings one out for Roy Finch. It's a block from Ryan Broyles. It looks like he has a first down. Where are they going to mark it? Yep, he'll have the first down with a gain of 11. Tyson Hartman made the stop for K-State. The three. Out of the pistol now. He's the all-time leader in passing yardage at Oklahoma. More than 10,000 career yards. Adding to that total, Broyles gets 9 in the K-State territory. They're going to mark it at the 49. A gain of 8. It'll be 2nd and 2. Emmanuel Lamour and Tyson Hartman made the tackle.
And the one thing that this Oklahoma receiving corps does very well is block. They block for each other.
They came up very quickly that time. Jones throws it away. He was under duress. Broyles has 7 catches already for OU. Here's Heather Cox.
Guys, another update on Oklahoma's Dominique Whaley. He is out, as you mentioned, already has a hard cast and ice on that left leg. I am being told that it is broken and that he has finished for the season. I was able to talk to Dominique briefly. He said the pain level is okay. It just hasn't kicked in. But about every Oklahoma player on the sideline has been over to wish him well. Certainly wish him a speedy recovery.
Indeed, your heart breaks for that young man. 3rd down and 2. Jones, 1st down. Finch banged into the tackler, Nigel Malone. Ball be marked at the 43. Sooners on the move again.
Roy Finch reminds me of an old Oklahoma Sooner, Joe Washington, when he's in space. Really difficult to cover.
And they come up to the line quickly, and it's intercepted. Nigel Malone looking for blockers. And down at the 46 of Oklahoma. Fifth interception of the season to lead the Big 12 for the junior, Nigel Malone.
Certainly had time to make the throw. It's to the two receiver side. Finch comes out underneath, and then Malone just jumps it. He jumps his coverage because it was stared down by Landry Jones. Look at the eyeballs. We're not the only ones who are looking at it. Well done.
22-yard return of the 8th interception of the year thrown by Landry Jones. Colin Klein. Gets blocks on the corner. Inside the 30. and finally pushed out of bounds inside the 20. They're going to mark it at the 15. What a turn of events in this game.
And what a great decision. This is the decision making I'm talking about right there in the run game. And Colin Klein runs it flawlessly. You come in and bite, I'm pulling that sucker out and I'm down the left sideline.
32-yard run. Klein at a 42-yard touchdown scamper on their last possession. Up to 75 yards rushing already. They're in the red zone. Hubert bounces outside, turns the corner, inside the five and down to the two. Devontae Hurst prevented the touchdown.
Sean, look at the Kansas State offensive line. They're starting to grow confidence. You can see it in the huddle. And it's all because of Klein. Klein is the key. We said it at the top of the game, and it will be all the way through. They feed off him.
First and goal. It was all Oklahoma. They raced to a 14-0 lead. Looked like they might blow Kansas State right out of their own stadium. They're having trouble getting the play in. And a timeout called by K-State. You know they didn't want to have that happen with momentum on their side. They couldn't find the right play. The time constraints, we move ahead to further action. Back in Manhattan, Kansas, Oklahoma leads 14-10. The Sooners were up 14-0. K-State has scored 10 unanswered and looking for more. First and goal from the two. They had trouble getting the play in. It's play calling by committee. They have two offensive coordinators, Del Miller on the left there and Dana Demo on the right. Bill Snyder is also involved. Bill candidly admits, sometimes I have a hard time making up my mind. So this is not all that uncommon, as K-State fans know, that they burn a timeout because they have trouble getting the play in. 7-0 for the first time since 1999. It's also the last time they were 8-0. Klein keeps, surges straight ahead. Touchdown.
That's just pure power, Sean, not only from the offensive line, but from Klein. A little bit of patience, a little bit of power. And it's soon to be a three-point lead. Watch them, just a scrum. Right up front. You saw 50, Nick Pitts. B.J. Finney, 66. And then Klein finishes it with the power.
Cantelli for the extra point. And it is the three-point lead for the Wildcats. You think back, Matt, they, with a minute to go in the first quarter, had negative yards of offense. They got that 11-yard run for their first down from Klein on the scramble. That was the first of six consecutive runs of double digits or more before the two-yard touchdown by Klein. Here's Reese Davis back in the studio. Thank you very much. And Bill Snyder talks so much about consistency, persistence, and the importance of team football. You saw the kickoff return, give them a little spark, set up the field goal. The interception by Malone set up this touchdown. All three phases work together. Big part of their formula of success. Short kick into the wind by Cantelli. Finch brought it back to the 38-yard line, was tackled by David Garrett. Here's a look at our Big 12 conference update brought to you by Dr. Pepper 10. Reese just mentioned it, Oklahoma State undefeated. Like K-State, they are the two teams atop the Big 12, the only teams in the conference without a loss, so each in control of its own destiny. But Oklahoma is as well, because They obviously play K-State today, and they have the Bedlam game in early December against Oklahoma State. Remarkable streak for OU. They haven't lost consecutive games in a single season since 2003, longest such streak in the country. Ryan Broyles up the far sideline. Across midfield and out at the K-State 46-yard line. What a first half Broyles is having, his eighth catch of the half.
He seems to have that thing every week, doesn't he? He's just a productive player.
Averages 9.5 catches per game. He's at 9 catches now. The previous play went for 16. That one goes for 4. Chopped down by Emmanuel Lemoore.
You watch him, he really knows how to separate, Sean, and he can pluck the ball. What I mean by that, he catches it with his hands away from his body, but he's got a great feel for that slot position. What they do a lot of times, just get the ball out to him. That's nothing more than a long handoff. He does it extremely well, and he'll do it at the next level as well.
He's not a very big young man, but he is strong. Jones zips one into coverage, and it is caught by Jazz Reynolds. Looked like there were two K-State defenders poised to pick that off, and somehow it wound up in the hands of Reynolds at the 18-yard line.
That I thought had a chance to be picked off, but Reynolds with a great catch. That is not a good one. That's a great one.
25-yard gain. First catch of the day for Reynolds, who's been coming on in recent weeks. Particularly down the field, he averages 20 yards per catch. From the 18. Oklahoma trying to reclaim the lead. It's Reynolds again. Touchdown. The ball came out after they signaled touchdown from the far side of the field.
The official on the goal line raised his hands. The official in the end zone waited. But there's the catch. And there he is extending the ball, breaking the plane. Ooh. Has control until the ball hits it. That's a touchdown. Now the ball comes out. Well, now the official on the sideline, Sean, he had his hands up right away. But you mentioned it. Ed Reynolds, he's really been coming on. They've got another one there who's another big play machine.
Now, he didn't have a catch in their first two games, but then he had 23 receptions in the next 5. Two big ones back-to-back there. Extra point is blocked. Did not get over the crossbar. Honeycutt, extra point blocked.
That's number 94, Guidry,
who blocked 2 field goals against Texas Tech, which is a big part of their win over Texas Tech. First player ever under Bill Snyder to block 2 field goals in the same game, and now he's blocked a PAT. Oklahoma went 62 yards on 4 pass plays, the last 2 to Jazz Reynolds, including an 18-yard touchdown pass, his 3rd touchdown of the season. And the extra point was blocked by the man on the right of your screen, Raphael Guidry, on a low kick by Michael Honeycutt. Landry Jones and the Sooners back in the lead. He's thrown 2 touchdown passes today.
He's efficient on that last drive. They're on, Sean. They're kind of like a machine.
The Bill Snyder's team will get it back. Patrick O'Hara kicking off with a win for the first time today. Tyler Lockett back for the kickoff. Brought one back 100 yards at Texas Tech 2 weeks ago against Texas Tech, and brought one back 97 yards at Kansas. The opening kickoff of the second half last week. He's going to try it from about 4 yards deep. And why wouldn't he? Brought it out across the 24-yard line.
Sean, we're going to show you Arthur Brown right there. He's the key for Landry Jones. Because what they're going to do is they're going to go play action inside. And now watch the bite. Here. This is where they want to get to with Ryan Broyles. It all comes together. He sees it immediately. Nice delivery, and you're in the end zone. And it's all set up because of this great catch by Reynolds. It's a one-hander, great concentration, and a big play.
Three Oklahoma touchdown drives have all taken less than 3 minutes. John Hubert weaved out to the 27-yard line from Waco, Texas, where he broke all of LaDainian Tomlinson's city high school rushing records, but wasn't highly recruited like so many of these K-State players.
Not a real big guy. You can see only 5'7", 185 pounds. Has very good vision, and that allows him to pick and choose inside. He does it pretty well.
Line just 1 for 3 passing for 5 yards, but they've started to find their rhythm on the ground. Klein bounced off the pile. Here comes Jefferson, who pulled him down just across the 30-yard line. Here's Reese.
All right, Sean, you told us about Tyler Lockett. He is indeed a dangerous kickoff return man, and so too is Jeffrey Demps of the Gators. Now, honesty compels me to say that Demps was actually caught from behind earlier in this game by Brandon Boykin. Not here. 99-yard kickoff return. Gators up 14-3 in the second.
Wow.
They can fly.
Demps caught from behind.
He must have been looking back or something. That kid, he and Rainey, they're fun to watch.
Third down and 5 now for the Wildcats, and here's another timeout. Second they've used while on offense here in the first half. Colin Klein was recruited by the previous coaching staff by Ron Prince and his bunch to be a drop back pocket passer. He's turned into a running quarterback, and he's run with great effectiveness all season long, including today.
And he runs through tackles. And Sean, the thing that's so impressive though is we talked about it a few times. It's been his decision making, and he has a great feel for that mesh point. And the mesh point, Sean, is that point where he puts the ball into the running back's hand, and then he makes the read. And then if you bite on that, he's pulling it out and he's gone. And he's done it very consistently. You can see second behind Denard Robinson with 670 yards. And today he's added a bunch more.
They are three of the best in the country dual threat quarterbacks. There are 6 quarterbacks in the country leading their team in rushing and in passing efficiency. And one of those 6 is Colin Klein. He pulls it down and runs on 3rd and 5 as the first down. Out to the 43-yard line. R.J. Washington made the tackle. It's a 13-yard gain.
Well, they anticipated man coverage, which they got. And Klein saw it right away. And then he just uses that big body. He runs through tackles, through linemen, linebackers, and secondary people alike. He's impressive.
Averaging 9.6 per rush today. He's on the verge of his 4th 100-yard rushing game of the season. Still 9:16 to go in the first half. Design roll to the right. Short throw. Catch made by Lockett. Out of bounds, Oklahoma 49. A gain of 8. It'll be 2nd and 2 for the Wildcats. All-time leading receiver here at Kansas State is Uncle Aaron, was also a standout for the Wildcats. 4th all-time here in receiving yardage. The pistol now for K-State. And that time, Klein might have made the wrong decision. It's a flag down to the field. Hubert was stopped for no gain by Ronnell Lewis.
John, I think you're 100% right. We've been talking about his decision-making. That was one of his poor ones.
Illegal formation, offense, 5-yard penalty, 2nd down.
Interesting, they decided to take it even though they stopped the play for no gain. Instead of 3rd and 2, it'll be 2nd and 7.
Watch Klein, he puts the ball into Hubert's hands, and now he's eyeballing this right here. And if he bites, then you should turn it up. Well, he does bite, and he hands it off. And so one of the few times today we've seen him make a poor decision.
Must have been anticipating that defender would be blocked, and he wasn't. Here comes a blitz. Klein throws quickly, and a good catch made for a first down. Chris Harper at the 46 of Oklahoma.
That's a heck of a nice throw right there by Klein. Right where it had to be, low and outside. Harper's the only guy who's going to make that catch, and of course it's a first down.
8-yard gain, first catch. Their leading receiver for the year, it's just his 27th catch. He's a transfer from Oregon. A lot of junior college transfers and transfers from four-year colleges. About half the two-deep are transfers. Klein kept it. He got rocked as he turned the corner. Stacy McGee, Ronnell Lewis, Sam Proctor. All in there to make sure that Klein paid the price for hanging on to the ball that time. There are the numbers we were talking about on the two deep. 17 junior college transfers. And that's been the formula from way back when he first turned the program around.
And that explains a lot why he's so big on responsibility and all the fundamentals, because usually you get the kids out of JUCOs that are not well disciplined.
Trouble again on the connection with Hubert. Klein looked to make the right decision to keep it that time, but it fell out of his hands. He recovered at the 41-yard line. Here comes third down and five. They've always recruited the junior college as well. Some people say, well, junior college kids, there's a reason why they're in junior college. Bill Snyder says, hey, you can find good kids in high school.
Sure.
You can find bad kids in high school. You can find good kids in junior college. You can find bad kids in junior college. We try to find the good kids in both places. Play clock running out. And here they go again.
Sean, that's one of those things. You talked about it earlier. You said they had the two play callers upstairs, and then it goes through Bill Snyder. Some have said they're play suggesters, and he makes the decision.
And I think that's true. Time to take a look at today's Aflac trivia question. Bill Snyder, one of three FBF's head coaches who've coached in a stadium with his name on it. We want to know who are the other two. It's over the history of college football.
Holy smokes.
It's a hard question.
We were crushing them the last few weeks, Sean. I think they just had to dig deep on
this. They wanted to make it a little harder. Yeah. Third down and six now for Bill Snyder's team at the Oklahoma 41-yard line. Holland Klein handed it off quickly to John Hubert. He has the first down. Bounces off tackles. What a run by Hubert. Finally down near the 15-yard line. And there's been some shaky tackling by the Oklahoma defense here in the first half.
Yeah, a lack of tackling, Sean. They've been getting blocked, and theirs run right through another. Jefferson runs through. They're not wrapping their arms. Javon Harris, number 30, they just... Hey, let me tell you something. All you high school players out there, it doesn't matter. Tackle them. The objective is to get them to the ground, not to just hit them.
Yes. Stoops and Brent Venables be livid. That's dreadful tackling. Here's Hubert again. He actually never was tackled. He slipped down at the 15 on the previous play, trying to make a cut. He gets to the 11 there, 4-yard gain. There's Brent Venables. His defense gave up 572 yards of offense in the loss to Texas Tech last week. The homecoming for Brent. He played here at K-State, was a fine linebacker. Honorable mention all Big Eight. Part of that coaching staff here with Bob Stoops under Bill Snyder, both former K-State assistants. 170 yards rushing now for K-State. And they had negative yardage for the game with a minute to go in the first quarter. What a turnaround. Klein. Pulled down. Good tackle that time by Tony Jefferson. Here comes another big third down.
What's happened here is they've been able to get into the second level, and that's past the defensive line, into the linebackers and the safeties, and they've just not tackled well. And, Sean, credit Colin Klein and also Hubert, 33, because they have not gone down easy. They're making you have to tackle.
Third down and three. They have to get the playoff this time because they don't have a timeout. And the crowd anxious again. They've seen this movie before. Klein throws, corner of the end zone. Caught but out of bounds. Harper fielded it out of the back of the end zone. Actually did not hang on. Had it for a moment and then lost it. But for a team that talks about doing all the little things right, exactly, this is not good. There are problems with getting plays in and getting them snapped. And that's a part of being disciplined.
That's a huge part of it, Sean.
Yep. And it really falls on the coaching staff to practice what it preaches.
You know, we talk about Bill Snyder and all that, but then when we drive up and see him where he parked, he crossed the line. He did it again here.
Field goal attempt to tie. And it is no good. What a disastrous ending to the drive. Anthony Cantelli hooks one wide left from 25 yards. After he made one with the wind from 54, this one into the wind, but that shouldn't have been a factor on a 25-yard kick. So they had the ball for 6 minutes and 53 seconds and come away with no points. And the coaches will reflect again on their part in that on the previous play. They were eyeing a touchdown in the lead, had to settle for the tying field goal attempt. They went wide, buffeted a bit by the wind. Roy Finch out to the 23, a gain of 3. Plenty of time for this Oklahoma offense to add to the lead. All 3 of their scoring drives have taken under 3 minutes. 4:10 to go in the half. They have all 3 timeouts. Andrew Jones throws, caught. Kenny Stills got away from Malone. Finally ridden out of bounds by Tyson Hartman. It looked like he was trying to punch the ball out. There is a flag now in the secondary. Second catch of the day for Stills.
Malone is probably their best corner. And he's got to make those tackles. It's the same thing that we saw out of Oklahoma. You've got to wrap your arms.
A 10-yard gain, and then what?
Illegal block in the back. Number 33 of the offense. 10-yard penalty from the end of the run. Second down.
Trey Miller, the fullback. So it sets up 2nd and 7. The clock is running. Oklahoma at its own 23. 3.5 to go in the half. Again, plenty of time for Jones. Catch made by Broyles. He swung back, but he had enough for the first down to the 31-yard line. 10 catches now for Broyles. For 105 yards.
Very good field awareness, knowing where the sticks are to get that first.
Pass batted down by Lutui in the middle of that defensive line. Batted it down.
And good thing Lutui gets his hand up, because Hannah's all alone in the middle of that defense. And he's gonna pick up some yardage.
2nd and 10. Pistol with Finch behind Jones. Just tuned in, Dominique Whaley. Suffered a left leg injury on the first play from scrimmage. Out for the year, we believe. Finch fighting for extra yardage. Stayed in bounds. Came up well short of the first down. And with 3 minutes to go in the half, a third down upcoming for Oklahoma. On its own 38, 3rd and 3.
Kansas State has not, in third short situations, gone to tight man coverage. They have played zones and been very patient all the way through, and it looks like we're going to get the same thing here again.
4 out of 5 on third down today for Oklahoma. Bill Snyder said, I don't know how you get close to Landry Jones. He's so well protected and gets the ball out so quickly. They haven't really pressured him much. Meshack Williams forced him out of the pocket. James Hanna the catch at midfield. Lunges forward for a first down to the 48-yard line of K-State. Ty Zimmerman pulled him down.
Remember when the ball was knocked down just a few plays previous? They came back to the same thing. See the middle of the field wide open.
14-yard gain. Jones pressured from behind but got it off, and it's intercepted again by Malone. The receiver Stills went down. No flags on the field. Second pick of the day by Malone.
He tried to go up. Malone had coverage. Still sitting there in his zone. Don't get beat deep. He runs with him. The ball's actually underthrown, Sean. Not a good throw. And Malone comes down with it. Second pick of the day.
Well, very windy conditions with gusts up near 30 miles per hour. Seeing the impact it's had on the kicking game and now perhaps the throwing game. Jones might have been anticipating more help from the wind that he got.
Yeah.
Nigel Malone, first year at K-State, one of those JC transfers. He's from City College of San Francisco. Hubert. They're a grinded out offense, and they've been moving well the last few possessions, Matt, but again, because they burned all those timeouts and they couldn't get plays in or snapped, they don't have any timeouts to work with, and they need them. They're going to go the length of the field.
Yeah, and they need to quicken their pace here also. The buck 40 to go. You've got to go faster than this.
Unless you're just content to take it to the house. Down by three. Lock at the catch, then a fumble, and they did not recover it inbounds. Jefferson knocked it out. Frank Alexander went sprawling on the turf to try to recover it. They'll mark it back where he lost the ball at the 36, but it's good for a first down on an 11-yard gain.
Yeah, Jefferson gets his hand right on the ball, and Sean, you said it right. Because there was no control, it goes back to the point where Lockett fumbled it.
Alexander had a shot at it inbounds, but did not possess it. Three catches for Lockett. And the clock is running, 1:10 to go. Lockett taken down. Nicely played by Aaron Colvin. Here's Reese Davis. Second and 12 here. They have to go a long way to get into field goal range, heading right into this stiff wind. Hubert fumbled the football. And it's recovered by Oklahoma. Ronnell Lewis has it at the 36-yard line. All they were trying to do was run out the clock, it appeared, and they turn it over.
They've had trouble with the mesh point. That time they get it fine. It's hit. Hubert gets the ball hit, does not protect it. Ronnell Lewis comes up with it.
Well, they dodged one bullet when the fumble went out of bounds. Not this time. It'll be a long field goal from here, but with this breeze, it might be doable for Honeycutt. His long is 44, but that's the only field goal they've tried this year longer than 40 yards. Landry Jones wants more than three. Looked like Broyles had a hard time picking up the ball. Covered by Alan Chapman. Let's answer today's Aflac trivia question. You want to take any guesses?
Well, the only one I could think of would be Bear Bryant.
At Bryant-Denny Stadium.
Right.
You are correct.
And
Ralph Shug Jordan at Jordan-Hare Stadium. I thought Bobby Dodd Stadium, but apparently they named it after Bobby Dodd after he coached. That's the Aflac trivia question for today. 14 seconds to go here at Bill Snyder Family Stadium. First half. A good one between two of the top 10 teams in the country. Pass incomplete, looking for Broyles. Again, Alan Chapman, the junior from San Francisco, in coverage. Third and 10.
Chapman had himself a pretty good jam right there on Broyles, which they haven't done enough of. I would get a jam on these receivers all the time because you're not getting any pressure, Sean, in here whatsoever on Landry Jones. He has had all kinds of time to throw.
Taking a lot of time to make sure they get the right play. Four receivers, two to each side. Finch to the left of Jones. 10 seconds to go in the half. Jones down deep and almost intercepted again. Off the hands of Ty Zimmerman. Now you wonder if they'll try the field goal. Yes, they will, with this sturdy breeze at their backs.
Nice throwing lane. Just step and throw. He missed Hannah. Now, you're right. It had a chance to be picked, but Hannah was wide open. Not a good throw.
There's Michael Honeycutt. He took over as the kicker when Jimmy Stevens went out with a muscle strain early in the year. Strong breeze at his back. This would be a career-long 52-yarder for the freshman from Richardson, Texas. Mentioned the only field goal they've tried all year over 40 yards by either Stevens or Honeycutt was a 44-yarder made earlier this year by Honeycutt. Of course, Honeycutt part of the loss last week. He had a rough week. He missed two short field goals. Went 1-for-3 in the three-point loss against Texas Tech. Tommy Tuberville knew what a big miss that was and a big part of the Red Raiders' upset win in Norman, ending Oklahoma's 39-game home winning streak. The same breeze that helped Cantelli kick a 54-yarder in this direction earlier in the game is at the back of Honeycutt. And that one is good. Just did. Wobble over the crossbar. Officially a 53-yarder to end the half. And without the wind, there's no way this makes it because it barely made it, and he didn't get all of it. Well, entertaining first half with momentum shifts, and here's Heather.
Coach Snyder, what adjustments did you make to have more success in the running game in the second quarter?
Well, I think we're just trying to, we're executing things that we do a little bit better. That's what it's all about is, you know, whether we can block and tackle on defense and things like that, but just execution, doing things the way you're supposed to do them.
When you were down 14-0 early, what did you tell your team to get them to respond?
Well, what we've said all year, you know, you just keep playing. I mean, that's what the game's all about. It's a 60-minute ball game, and you got to play every snap, and you just keep playing is what we say. Keep rowing the boat.
Coach Snyder, thank you. Row that boat, boys.
Well, both teams true to form. K-State rushed for 176 in the half, and Landry Jones threw for 290 in the half for Oklahoma. 23-17 Oklahoma.